The Philippines' COVID-19 special advisor recommends downgrading the quarantine status in Metro Manila. Dr. Ted Hermosa believes the National Capital Region can impose a modified enhanced community quarantine. That's as long as the local government units impose localized hard lockdowns in areas considered as hotspots.
Tayo na ngayon nagretala tayo ng 10,000 yung ni-report mo from many days na over 14,000. Parang mga tatlong consecutive days yun na 14,000. Tapos kahapon bumaba na. Sana tuloy-tuloy na yung pagbaba at madalian ang desisyon ng IATF na luwagan ang ating quarantine. Opinion ko lang ang masusunod. Ako kung ako namumuno sa IATF, bababa ako sa MECQ.
Meanwhile, Hermosa notes 80% of those confined in hospitals due to COVID-19 are unvaccinated.
Merong remainder, mga about 10 to 15%, one dose pa lang ang natanggap. So alam naman natin yun na pwede pa rin mahawa yung one dose. At may mga maliit na porsyento na naka 2 doses na na-admit din sa ICU. At ito naman, nung pag sinusuri namin, sila yung may mga comorbidity or immunosuppression. Yung parang nahihirapan talaga ang bakuna na mag-effect ng immune response. Base sa datos na ganito, talagang may epidemya pa ng unvaccinated.
The Metro Manila Council may release today its recommendation for the region's next quarantine classification. See, the council met Tuesday night to discuss the matter. Metro Manila Development Authority Chairman Benhur Abalos set to hold a press conference later this afternoon to announce the outcome of that meeting. Metro Manila is currently under lockdown due to the ongoing surge in COVID-19 cases. The council's chairman and Parañaque City Mayor Edwin Olivares earlier said the recommendation will be based on the effects of the lockdown set to end on Friday. More movement for fully vaccinated Filipinos. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion is pushing for this to help jumpstart the economy. He says those who have been fully inoculated should be allowed to enter more establishments once the lockdown is lifted.
If we allow the vaccinated to go to the malls, to the restaurants, to the spas, then I think we can create some economic activity already by opening up these malls, spas, and restaurants. Pagtapos na yung ECQ, no? Nangyayari yan, pag sapat na ang bakuna natin dito. At palagay ko hindi rin papayag yung IATF kung kulang pa ang bakuna natin. We have to protect the unvaccinated kasi talagang highly vulnerable at this point in time sila dahil sa Delta, no?
Almost one-third of Filipinos do not have access to COVID-19 vaccination sites. That's according to a new social weather station survey conducted in late June. Luzon topped the areas with the least accessible vaccination sites at 35%. This is followed by Visayas with 29% and Mindanao at 26%. Majority of those who had access to inoculation centers were from Metro Manila. Meanwhile, around 50% of Filipinos believe the government's vaccine rollout is still slow, more than 6 months since it began. But Malacañang assures the public measures are being taken to pick up the pace of the inoculation program. So far, the Philippines has administered 28.3 million COVID-19 shots. A total of 12.7 million people have been fully vaccinated. The Philippines logged another 10,000 new COVID-19 infections Tuesday. Total cases are now at 1,765,000, of which 105,000 are active. The health department's data show average daily infections in the country grew by almost 4,000 in just a week. Among those registering a high number of new cases is Metro Manila. The Octa Research Group says the current surge is filling the region's hospitals beyond capacity.
Yung sa hospitalization, we have to admit na ano, kasi right now we're averaging 3,000 cases per day sa Metro Manila. Based sa studies namin, lagpas na yan sa surge capacity ng hospitals. What that means is, yung numero na yan, higit na yan sa minimum na nagsasabi na hindi mababawasan yung laman ng hospitals at madadagdagan lang at madadagdagan. Ang surge capacity na na-compute namin dati nasa mga 2,500. Baka nga less than ng ngayon. So ibig sabihin, mm-hmm. habang mas marami pa sa mga 2,000 cases, hindi bababa yung mga admissions sa hospital.
More Delta variant cases have also been detected in the country. In the latest batch, nearly half of the 373 samples were positive for the highly contagious strain.